Hello, I'm Maha. Welcome to my channel, Maha's Musings, where today I'll be talking about and reviewing Charlotte's Web by E.B. White. Now, this is a children's classic, but adults can enjoy it just as much as well. So I started reading this book this year, and I was really happy that I added this to my TBR winter stack of books as well. Now, let me start off with the plot of the story. It starts off with a young girl called Fern, who's around 8 years old. That's around the same age as you, Musa.
No, I'm older. I'm 8 and a half.
That's true. And actually, we both thought that Charlotte was the girl's name.
Yeah, but it's actually the spider's, and Fern, the girl's name, sounds like the spider's name.
That's true. So basically, Fern has a bunch of small animals, pigs, who are, you know, at the house because her father's a farmer, but one of the small pigs is a runt, and she overhears her father telling the mother that we have to do away with it. So Fern is very upset about that, and she decides to keep this little pig for herself and look after it, and she calls him Wilbur. But after a while, Wilbur grows pretty big and he has to leave because he can't afford to keep him anymore. So Wilbur is sold for $6 by Fern to her uncle, Zuckerman. And so Wilbur goes off to that farm, and it's over there in the barn at Zuckerman's farm that he meets Charlotte. And that's where they strike up an unlikely friendship. So what are the pros to this story? Well, the story has quite a lot of pros. For one, it has quite a lot of life lessons to it.
It has a good moral at the end of the story.
That's true. It does have a good moral. And some of the important themes in the story are friendship, kindness, and sacrifice. And some of the lessons that, you know, I came across have to do with, I'll put them forth in the form of a question. For example, what can we learn from animals, or what can animals teach us? And how did Charlotte's patience serve her, and how did it serve Wilbur? And how important was integrity and keeping promises for Charlotte? Aside from these questions, one of the most important aspects of this book are the powerful words in it, the vocabulary. When Charlotte decides to save her friend Wilbur from the chopping block, she comes up with an idea that has to do with words, important magical words, which she weaves into her web and that catches the attention of humans. Another aspect to powerful words is the vocabulary, which, you know, third, fourth, fifth, sixth graders can learn a lot from. Words like bestir.
Even seventh graders.
You're right, even seventh graders. Bestir, sedentary, magnum opus.
I've heard you heard magnum opus before.
And idiosyncrasies. And they just come in the story as you're reading them organically, and they stay in your mind much after, you know. It's one of the best ways to teach kids how to increase the vocabulary. And one of the most beautiful parts of this story is the setting. The setting has this most, you know, enchanting ambience. The ecosystem within the barn has these different animals and their dynamics, you know, playing up, each with a different personality. And it just gave a very peaceful feel to it. Twilight settled over Zuckerman's barn, and a feeling of peace. Swallows passed on silent wings in and out of the doorways, bringing food to their young ones. I just love it here, said Wilbur. I love everything about this place. Of course you do, said Charlotte. We all do. So what makes Wilbur so endearing? You know, for me, he came across as somebody who was more gullible and a little foolish. To me, it was Charlotte who was, you know, just unbelievably unreal and smart and purposeful, you know. For me, she was the star.
Hey, look at Charlotte, the star of the show.
That's right. I also love how humor is imbued within the story. "Too many things on my mind," said Wilbur. "Well," said the goose, "that's not my trouble. I have nothing at all on my mind, but I have too many things under my behind."
The goose is my favorite character, and then Templeton.
Ah, Templeton. Who can forget Templeton the rat? So, you know, I realized that even though I was reading this book in my adult years, there was something very special about it because it held more of a meaning to me. You know, like the lessons and the meaning that came from the story had a more in-depth feel to it. And this is a book that, you know, you can read at any time of the year and at any age as well. You don't have to be a kid to appreciate it. In fact, the meaning just gets more deeper as you grow older. So what are the cons to this book? Well, there are some cons. One of them is that, you know, it depicts that, you know, if you are a prized animal with, you know, medals and ribbons, you will be saved from the chopping block, which Wilbur was, you know. And it just harks back to that political message in George Orwell's Animal Farm, that all animals are created equal, but some are more equal than others. And in this respect, I didn't like how Charlotte was ignored or overlooked. I mean, she was somebody with a lot of purpose, a lot of heart, and extremely hardworking.
If the farmers knew that Charlotte was making the webs, they would still kill Wilbur.
Yeah, so, you know, when you put it that way.
That's why Charlotte needs to be overlooked by the farmers.
Nobody of the hundreds of people who had visited the fair knew that a grey spider had played the most important part of all. That's right, c'est la vie. And you know, Charlotte had already cleverly worked out that humans are not very smart. And she banked on that observation of hers to save Wilbur. And it worked. It worked. So what would I give this book? I'd give this book 4.5 stars out
of
5.
You always give every to-be-read book a 4.5 stars.
No, I didn't give the last one that, Musa. And so this one definitely deserves a 4.5 star out of 5.
It always ends with a half and a half.
Because, you know, of the setting, the dialogue, the characters, the memorable characters, the quotes from the book, the life lessons. I mean, they all came together to give this very heartwarming feel to it. And I also felt that, you know, at the end of the story, it was also a little sad and touching as well. And I want to read a quote, a very special quote from this book. "Why did you do all this for me?" he asked. "I don't deserve it. I've never done anything for you."
"You have been my friend," replied Charlotte. That in itself is a tremendous thing.
So with that quote, I shall leave you and thank you so much for joining us today for the book review, Charlotte's Web. And you can also find me on Instagram where I write my book reviews and on Goodreads as well. And do subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. So I look forward to any comments or any suggestions or even criticisms that you may have. They'll always be very helpful and I always respond to them as well. So have a great weekend and bye for now.